everyone, welcome back to the show. Now, if you missed the first segment, then you should know that we will be sharing interesting stories of events that are happening all around the world on today's show. And once again, we're going back to Brazil and the 2014 Soccer World Cup, which is happening just next month. Of course, all soccer fans out there, I'm sure, are very excited. But there are concerns that the infrastructure that's in place in Brazil right now may not really be able to support the World Cup, and many questions have been raised by experts. Of course, until the event actually does happen, we may never know how it's going to turn out. But until then, let's go see some of the problems that are being caused by the World Cup in Brazil. Bus drivers in Sao Paulo went on strike for a second day on Wednesday, May 21st, snarling transit and leaving hundreds of thousands stranded in South America's largest city, less than a month before it hosts the opening World Cup football match. Drivers and fare collectors, following a dissident faction of the local union, walked off the job on Tuesday, leaving vehicles parked on major roads and closing more than half the terminals in Brazil's business capital without giving warning of the imminent gridlock. The strike in Sao Paulo, generally one of Brazil's most orderly cities, highlights growing uncertainty over the country's ability to pull off one of the world's largest sporting events in 12 cities. Many football fans are expected to rely on public transportation to get to stadiums on game days. Sao Paulo has limited metro service, and its train stations were dangerously overcrowded both days, with passengers nearly crushed on escalators during the evening rush. Going from Brazil all the way to Malaysia, this is a story about two new visitors to Malaysia, and they're there on a very diplomatic tour, but they're not really humans. So let's go see who they are. A pair of giant pandas arrived in Malaysia on Wednesday, May 21st, from Chengdu, China, to begin a 10-year stint in the country. The pandas, known as Fu Wa and Feng Yi, are on loan from China as part of the Giant Panda Conservation Project, signed between Putrajaya Malaysia and Beijing in 2010. Malaysian media said they were initially scheduled to arrive in April as part of China's panda diplomacy, marking 40 years of diplomatic relations between the two countries. It was postponed due to criticism from Chinese relatives and the Beijing government over Malaysian authorities' handling of the disappearance of flight MH370. The pandas are set to be housed inside a $7.76 million specially built climate-controlled complex in the Malaysia National Zoo, where researchers hope their presence will raise awareness about wildlife and environmental protection. The upkeep of the pandas will cost the country $1 million per year. And with that interesting story on the pandas in Malaysia, we're going for a very short break, but back on Good Morning Sri Lanka with more interesting stories. Stay with us.
Fast, faces pass and I'm homebound. Staring blankly ahead, just making a way through the crowd. And I need you, and I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall to the sky. Do you think time went past me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I can just see you tonight. There's always times like these when I love you, and I wonder if you ever think of me. Cause everything's so wrong, I don't belong, living in your precious memory. Cause I need you, and I miss you, and now I want.
Us by, 'cause you know I'd want.